Many Americans have seen or heard of Amanda Gorman numerous times by now. She is the youngest inaugural poet, a recent graduate of Harvard University, and the first to be named the National Youth Poet Laureate. She was born in 1988 and was raised by her mother, Dr. Joanne Wicks, who is a sixth grade teacher. She grew up with two siblings, one of which is her twin sister, who is also an activist as well as a filmmaker. Before Amanda was named the first ever National Youth Poet Laureate, she was also named as the first ever Youth Poet Laureate of Los Angeles at the age of 16. But rising to where she is today was not a very easy path. In order to get to where she stands now, Amanda had to overcome a speech impediment, which manifested itself after having chronic ear infections as a young child. This led to her developing an auditory processing disorder where she frequently dropped letters, most often the letter R. But she was able to work through it and become an incredible orator she is today.
But finally, I had a moment of realization where I thought, if I choose not to speak out of fear, then there's no one that my silence is standing for.
Her inaugural poem, The Hills We Climb, inspired many people across the country. Amanda Gorman even went trending on various social media platforms on Inauguration Day. She stated that after seeing the insurrection at the Capitol, that was when the poem really came to life.
And yes, we are far from polished, far from pristine, but that doesn't mean we are striving to form a union that is perfect. We are striving to forge our union with purpose.
For there is always light. If only we're brave enough to see it. If only we're brave enough to be it. Amanda Gorman's message of hope and unity continues to spread across the nation as we speak. This has been Kevin. Stay safe, stay strong, and stay united.